Hello again, I'm Okwiri Agbosoremi, and it's another edition of Public Conscience on Radio, a production of the Progressive Impact Organization for Community Development with support from the Makato Foundation. I'm happy to be with you again on the program and as regular with my co-presenter, Chukwudi Okoli-Ugbaja.
It's a happy thing to be around again.
And we are still handling the issue of extortion of money in the process of registering a child at birth, call it rete corruption, at the base of some of our key institutions. The fact is, Chukwudi Okoli-Ugbaja, it is free to register a child at birth with a free birth certificate.
That is what it is supposed to be. Incidentally, the opposite seems to be the case. And this time around, we are talking to one of our regular contributors who has had some experience of the said distortion.
And the issue again is that registration of birth, as I said, is supposed to be free. And we repeat our earlier point made in our earlier episodes of the program that the UN Charter has provisions that makes such registration the right of the child. We have in the studio Mr. Osilama Umar Suleiman. Of course, he is not new to the issue. He's called us to tell us, I paid for my child birth certificate. And he will join us to discuss the topic, and we want to welcome him to the studio. Thank you for joining us on the program.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning, Nigeria.
Now, the deal, as it were, what was your likely experience like concerning the issue we are addressing? What was your experience?
Of course, it's obvious. It's more like a normal thing. I had 4 kids. So usually, much after the bed, what they say to you is, of course, you know, it's more like a cubicle. You have those guys. I don't know. I mean, they'll tell you, go there for your child certificate.
Where you are supposed to go to and register the bed.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. It's attached to the hospital. It's 4 cubicle. I don't want to mention the hospital's name anyway. So they say to you, in clear terms, you have to pay money. There's no two ways about it. And I paid. I paid for all the 3 of them.
How much did you pay each time?
The first one, I paid 1,000 naira. This and nobody. Second one, what happened? The second one, I didn't register her almost immediately.
You went home first before you came back?
I went home for a longer time. I went for a very longer time. So when my wife and I went there for the decision, she had actually used a middle name, which to me, I think I don't want it. So when we now had the last baby, I said, okay, go and redo, then let's have it too. That's a fresh certificate for the both of them.
Okay. So it will be uniform?
Yeah, it will be uniform. I don't want that middle name. I just wanted to have the normal Muslim
uniform
name.
Uniform name for the babies,
so that is carrying
my... paid again?
I paid, and I have to pay for the two of them. The two other ones I paid for the both of them, especially. So
can you remember how much you paid?
I do very well. I paid for 4,000 for each of them.
4,000?
4,000, yes.
For
I paid
each of them?
I paid 4,000. If I gave the money, I kind of money. Do you want... I mean, because when we had the baby... the lady that actually said to my wife, if you take her away and come back much after, you have to pay 4,000 naira. If you're doing it almost immediately, you pay 1,000 naira. I said to her, okay, tell me, I want to do 4 other ones. So let me go home and think about the name I go to my wife. I don't have the name for her yet. Let me go home, think about the name to give to her. Because Islamic, after 7 days, we give baby's name. So let me go get the name for that. Come back. We came back and we clear terms. You have to pay money.
But on your own part, did you insist on registering them free? Did you know they could be registered free? They should really be.
Yes, I did. This I know.
What was the reaction from
them? You know, they have a way of doing this thing. They have a way of working on you, kind of, I would say. What they do is, first of all, they kind of, you know, as it is, as a person, you are happy having the child.
Yes.
As a person, because if you ask me to pay 20,000 for anything for my baby, I would just say no. They me having a brand new baby that, I'm happy, you know, I'm happy to have this thing.
So you just want to...
This is the 4,000 wasn't really my problem, per se. I asked the woman, madam, this is supposed to be free from National Population Commission. So, I know about it, it's supposed to be free. So, you know, we pay money, they collect money. You get, we pay money, everybody. If I not me alone, I saw other people paying. So do I have to say I'm not paying?
Which confirms the fears or what our correspondent who investigated this, the ICIR correspondent that reported, said that many people are actually aware that this is free, but they are compelled by circumstances to pay. But what do you think should be done?
To a level you really cannot help.
Yes.
It's corruption. in the sense that, for instance, you cannot imagine going to a place, say you probably you are in a queue for instance. Everybody try to follow the queue, like humbly follow the queue as you go. You get there, some other person come for the other side and they try to pay money and they give in. Mm-hmm. You discover you'll be waiting. You
for them to
waiting
serve
for get them to serve you. You wait endlessly.
Okay, let us just before we come back to you, let us tell you out listening out there that you can reach us through 090-2265-6167 on WhatsApp. On WhatsApp, please. You can reach us, just drop us a message now. Tell us your experience. If you have I guess we have so many people out there who want to tell us their experiences on how they went about paying and collecting their birth certificate after they have paid. Please, our WhatsApp number to drop your number if you cannot call us, because we're going to give you a number to call now. But if you cannot call us, send us a message 090-2265-6167. That is 090-2265-6167. Let your phone let your messages come on this number. But just before the messages will come, Chukwudi,
I wanted to actually muse over: the older the child gets, the more the money you have to pay because the child was not registered at birth. I mean, is it a crime to get older before getting a birth? Gentlemen, I mean, it doesn't make sense to me.
I think it was one of the ways to compare them to pay the 1,000. If you come back next time, you pay 4,000, but just pay 1,000 now.
There will be a psychology, right?
This is psychology. These are some of the things. I think we can actually open the phones for those who want to who are listening, who want to tell us their experiences, who have suggestions. Particularly if you have passed through it, you have a baby, you have paid for a birth certificate for your child, which is supposed to be free. You can reach us and let us see who is calling. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. We're hearing you. Thank you for joining us. Where are you calling from? What's your name? Go straight to the point.
My name is Joe. I'm calling you from Kuwa.
Yes. You paid?
My name is Joe.
Yeah. Did you pay?
I paid 3,000 two times.
In which hospitals are these?
3,000 naira.
Yeah. Which hospitals are these?
Sorry?
Where did you pay this money?
At Metama General Hospital.
Metama General Hospital, Abuja.
Abuja.
Go on, please.
It is terrible because it's even good when we get enlightenment like this to open the eyes of the people. But once you get to the hospital, it's just like police station. They will change everything for you. And, you know, they will convince you. And the joy that you are coming with a baby, it now becomes difficult for you to now start making trouble. In fact, people around there will just say, okay, you're not paying, just leave, let us pay and let's go. No, that's the truth. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Thank you very much. We have definitely some many calls coming, people with experiences. Hello.
Hey, Adeomi Daniel.
Adeomi Daniel, how much did you pay?
When you are not around, when your police brought this issue, I told them, Yapo in Kaimo here. I'm not talking of Edo State. I'm not talking of Osun State. In Abuja here, Kaimo. Just wondering her from Benga to the place. You know what the woman said? She said that I should not blame her. The money is not going to her pocket. I should go to MPC and the Minister of Health. Last time I told your colleagues that Mr. Chukwudi, that if they want us to end this matter, you people should help us go to MPC. Whoever heads the MPC should come and tell us that we are lying. Go for Minister of Health. Let the director in charge of all this come and tell us that we are lying. Let's do it face off. Let them challenge us. Because this government and this Nigeria, we like to deny things. Before you know now, if you people go to their offices, they may not allow you to see them. They will say we are lying or we hate them. You know the system of Nigeria.
Mr. Adeomi will definitely bring them here. Thank you very much. We are going to get the NDC officials here.
You people should help us bring them next week.
Thank you. Thank you. I will have more callers. Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Vivian in your college.
Thanks for joining us. That's a female voice, I guess.
Well, it's not a female voice, it's a man's voice.
Okay, it's a man's voice. Oh. Okay, tell us the story now.
Suddenly, I went to Wuse General Hospital to register and to get the birth certificate. The one from National Population Commission. There is a particular desk where you enter general hospital, to go straight to them, that is where they have their canopy. So they will issue the certificate of the death certificate to you. They will ask you of the age of your child, if it is 3 years, 2 years, 1 year, or maybe 1 week or the day. So they will ask you all this and they will ask you to pay the money and they will call it.
All right, yeah. Thank you, because your line is not actually too clean for us, but I've gotten your story. There's a cubicle, there's some place they have created inside the hospital. You go there and they demand from me, say he paid 3,000 naira.
And we need to ask from the next callers whether they demand that the children be seen before registered.
Well, let's go to the next caller. Hello.
Yeah, my name is Mr. Wachosu.
Yeah, did you pay?
Yes, I paid four times for my four children. Then the fourth one that broke my heart was my niece that says with me, this is a lady girl. I went there to register her. That lady there in this library in area 2. She said that I must pay 7,000. And I begged that lady that day, the total money in my wallet that day was that 7,000 naira.
Why were you begging? Did you know that it is free?
But I asked her, even when I begged her for 5,000, she refused. I asked her, is this money being received? She said no. That if I don't want, and because of what I wanted to use the stuff to do, I have to come back to pay her 7,000 naira that day. And she collected without giving me receipt.
She, that's the NPC office, Abi?
The health center in area 2.
The health center in area 2, yes. When was this? When did you do this?
This should be around February.
This year?
Yes, this year.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
7,000 naira.
Thank you so much. We have some more people who have experiences reaching us. Hello.
Hello, my name is Mr. Anthony, calling from Cuba.
Anthony, thank you so much. Did you pay?
Yes, I paid in Cuba General Hospital.
You paid in Cuba General Hospital?
The month of May, yes.
This May?
Yes, I paid Cuba General Hospital.
How much did you pay?
I paid 1,000 naira.
1,000?
Yes. Aside that, there is something they are doing in the hospital now that I think the government needs to know about it.
About birth registration?
Even when they delivered my baby, the normal money that government said we should pay will go to the cubicle and pay. But inside the labor ward, the nurses will connive and collect 6,000 naira from you.
All right, let's take some other persons. That's a different dimension altogether. Hello.
Hello, my name is Mike. I'm calling from Dusse.
Are you paid?
Yes, I paid.
How much?
I paid 3,500. Actually, the date my wife went to the hospital to deliver, we requested for the birth certificate. They said the person to issue us was not around. Then we left. She came back the second time and instantly the person was not around. So that makeup we couldn't go. So when we had the second baby, that was when we requested the person was around. Now, okay, give us this one and the other. The last baby that you were not around, and they requested that we should pay. And we paid the money for it.
Now, did they see the first baby? Did you take the first baby or the second baby to the hospital before they issued this certificate?
No.
The name of the hospital?
Dusse Alaji Health Center.
Okay, thank you so much. It's a harvest of payments at our various health centers. Hello. We have somebody on the line. Hello.
I was speaking with Mr. Sylvester Imoto.
Sylvester Imoto, thank you so much. Did you pay?
Actually, yes. I paid. It was Maraba Specialist. So it's 1,000 naira we paid.
Maraba Specialist Hospital.
You know, this thing is not even new thing. It's just like what other people said. When your wife put to bed safely and said you should pay 1,000 or 2,000, you will be happy paying it. So everybody are paying it over there. Thank you.
When you say I, sir, I don't know if everybody will understand it, but thank you very much.
I thought it was Obilu. I, sir.
It was taking me back home.
Oh, really?
Yes. Hello.
Hello. Good morning. Yeah, my name is Ibrahim. I'm calling you from Kumwa.
Thank you so much, Ibrahim.
Thank you. I had three children, all in the same hospital, Garki Hospital.
Garki Hospital.
In 2015, I paid 500 naira in 2015. In 2013, I paid 500 naira for the first baby. The second baby in 2015, I paid 500 naira. Then in 2018, I had my third child. The woman asked me to pay 3,000 naira. I was not curious that that goat is not even an aristocratic or a geometric goat. It was an exponential goat in the house. That is 3,000 naira. So I just don't want to sound too controversial, and I just allow it to be. I paid 3,000 from 500 naira to 3,000 naira. Can keep officer inside the immunization room. Thank you.
Okay. If you want to send us a message, it's 090-22-65-61-67. That is 090-22-65-61-67. But the calls are still coming. And let's take more. Let's see before we come back to the guests in the studio. Hello.
This is Ayo Fabio from Federal Secretariat now.
Ayo from Federal Secretariat.
Yes.
Go on.
I also paid at the Kubuaje Hospital.
How long ago?
The last one we paid was in March.
March this year.
And you paid three times.
500 naira. But you know that they will just cite you. Even I insisted, I told my wife to insist, but I wouldn't want to go through the rigor of going to the office later, paying 2,025, because I know people pay that much. Well, by the time they cite you, it's not a new bomb to buy coke for us. At least you need to celebrate. Before you know, you bring down the 500.
So the celebrations.
I don't know why it's like that.
The celebration starts from hospital, whether you like it or not.
The last one we had started from theater because we're ahead at transom. I had to cop out 6,500 because my wife was already on the table. So they just said, oh, guys, you have to pay 6,500. I was quarreling, but so I just have to use my wisdom. Don't let them tamper with my wife and my baby.
And if you want to send a message to us, it's 090-22-65-6167. That's the Primark WhatsApp number, so that we can continue to harvest your details even after we have left the studios. We have more calls coming. Hello. Hello. Yeah, thank you for breaking it. I think this is a female voice.
A lady, finally. Tell us your name.
My name is Jane. I'm coming from
Duse. From Duse.
Yeah,
you
did my own free.
You did your own free?
December last year.
You did it free?
Yes, they good. Said from bed it's free. Then afterwards, it's 8,000 naira.
At bed, it is free. Afterwards, it's how much?
After 60 days of bed, it's 4,000 naira.
It's 4,000 naira. At bed in the hospital, it is free, and she got it free.
Yes.
But they told her if she comes back next time after 60 days, she'll pay for that.
Where is this place?
Wusejera
Hospital. Okay, thank you so much, madam, and breaking the ice on the female voice on the program. More women should tell us their experiences.
Hello.
Hello.
Abdullah is my name, calling from Kujie.
And you paid?
No.
You didn't pay? Where was this hospital?
Abuja Atafi Clinic.
Abuja where?
Abuja Atafi Clinic.
Atafi Clinic.
Atafi, there is this estate that they used to call Abuja Atafi.
Is it a private? Is it a private hospital or public hospital?
It's public.
Public hospital.
Yeah.
And how long ago was this?
That was last year. Early this year.
Wonderful.
February or March.
They registered and then they gave you a birth certificate and you walk away free of charge.
Free.
What? Wonderful. There's hope.
The NDC staff there is a wonderful guy, combined with the nurses there. We did it free. A lot of people, not me alone.
Thank you very much. That gives us some
hope. Oh, it does.
That gives us some
hope. That actually gives us something to leverage.
Let's see if the next caller also did free. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Your name?
This is Rafael calling from Transcorp.
From Transcorp?
Yes.
Okay, go on. Did you pay?
I did not pay. I did my inspection.
Where was this?
In their office, actually.
Okay, you are taking your baby home before you went there.
Yes, I didn't bother collecting at the hospital. I just left.
Did they ask you at the hospital?
They asked me, but I did not respond to them.
What was your conversation at the hospital?
They say I should register for the baby, but being that I have an experience with my first two babies, I just refused.
Did you pay for those earlier children?
I did not pay for any one of them because it was done in their very office.
Okay, you insisted that you are not going to pay and you successfully registered without paying.
Yes, I good. Did not pay.
Good. Thank you so much. These are wonderful experiences.
Oh, yeah.
Hello. I guess we have somebody who wants to share similar experience. Hello.
Hello. My name is Solomon. I'm calling from Kokoa. Yeah, mine didn't happen in Abuja. I moved to Abuja last year from Kaduna.
Yes.
So these things happen almost everywhere. So I gave birth, my wife gave birth in the private hospital, and it was time to get the birth certificate. The private hospital didn't charge us, but I think there was this, the lady from the population commission was there. So immediately you give birth, or you come back for vaccination, and it was during vaccination. So we came back after a month for vaccination, and they asked my wife to pay. She asked her to pay.
How much did she pay?
1,000 naira.
In Kaduna?
She mentioned that it was free, but that we needed to pay for the stamping or something. There was something she attached to it. But the certificate itself was to be paid for the stamping or something.
Can you remember the name of this hospital in Kaduna?
It was Harmony Hospital, Harmony.
Where is it located in Kaduna?
Harmony Hospital is in Banawa.
Banawa?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you paid the 1,000 for the, I think there was a stamping or something, but he declared that it was free, but we had to pay.
They had to use some tricks to tell you to pay.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much. That's a Kaduna experience. Do we have a similar experience elsewhere? Before we come back to the guests in the studio. Hello.
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 I'm calling from one.
Your name?
Ogbona is my name.
Ogbona. Thank you. Go ahead. Did you pay?
Yeah, I paid three times, man.
Three times?
Yes, at Metama General Hospital.
Metama General Hospital?
Yes, that was where I paid.
The last time you paid, how much did you pay?
I paid 1,000. They said it's to laminate the certificate.
To laminate it?
Yes, so it is.
They okay. Did you pay for these are provided services? They said they will. Did they laminate the certificate?
They did. And the issue is this: they will not give it to you the day your wife gave birth to the baby. You have to come back 2 weeks.
And how much did you say you paid?
I paid 1,000 naira.
1,000 naira.
The target, they want to eliminate the laminate.
They target a lamination fee.
So they say.
And they provided that service of laminating it.
They did.
Okay.
Obviously, that should not take more than 200 naira.
Okay, now, well, those people almost, I think one of them, they said they didn't pay.
Yes.
The others also paid. And you can see the amount, told us just now, it's a small amount of money. You are excited, you are happy, and then they tell you, if you don't pay now, you will pay more next time. There are circumstances, some of them put it to lamination and a lot of other things in order to collect money from the people. Let's come to the how to solve the problem, Mr. Silama. How do you think we can solve the problem?
I think I'll simply say, to the best of my knowledge, my understanding, here and now, corruption is endemic. It's very, very difficult. Like I said to my friend recently, we were discussing corruption. I said to him, I think even like we choose to see, Mr. Integrity, Mr. President, I love all that. I think if certain things are not put in motion to fight this, he would just be like we say in the dancer where I come from, Waka Pass. He would just Waka Pass. Yes, that's a, I'm from Edo State anyway, so we are good at slang speaking. So he would just Waka Pass. Because I think we should find a way to address these issues. No, we have so many of them. This is just one. And I think it's one of the minutest ones within the hospital circle. So many other corruption and everywhere.
At different layers.
Oh, miraculous me. You know, so we just have to find a way to address this. I don't know. I'll say whether I think it should be the Minister of Health or the Population Commissioner in charge of this, whoever is heading that department should be brought to account and asked who are those who return this money to. They are not restricted. You give this money, they are not restricted, of course. I paid, I was never issued a receipt.
When you look at the Nigerian people themselves, the mothers who are having the babies, the fathers who are so happy that the baby has arrived, do you think that we are kind of lackadaisical towards accepting some of our...
And we just accept it.
Or is it just that some of us don't
not
know?
Not at all. Let me tell you my experience, for instance. Like I said to you, I'm trying to give you an analogy from being a queue to buy fuel, and everybody happens to say, stunting for the other side, giving bribe and they get their fuel, you remain in one place for hours.
Because
you do not want to do that. You say, okay, let me just get this done and get moving.
Is that like
same way.
It's also like the policeman stopping you and they take your papers, they walk away.
God bless you. Transfer it with different person and all that. They keep you waiting.
Then you just want to get out. Somebody is asking, you tell the person no. Just like one of the callers that said, I didn't pay because I know that I shouldn't pay.
Yes. Okay, in my case, I resisted. And to the best, it's been sponsored by foreign agents. I said to this woman, I said that this thing is even sponsored. So it's not, we're not even finished money. This is not even Nigerian motivation. So I'm going to people, I said to her, I can send Oga, if you like, ring bell. That was the language. Ring bell, keep shouting. I mean, keep shouting, shout to her, everyone, you must pay. And she walked away. And then came to me,
maybe if you had gone to their office. Because it takes some effort.
Yes, I agree.
Maybe you are in a hurry, you are a businessman, you are traveling the next day.
Was I in a hurry? No. I wasn't in a hurry per se. But I look at it, even if I go to the office, am I not going to meet certain sorts of people? Because I know the woman said to me they are not the staff of
NPC.
Staff of the hospital.
Yes.
Yeah, the hospital.
They are from a different agency, yeah. I think. They are not from the hospital.
Yeah.
So everyone was talking saying this thing. I don't have a doctor who is a visiting officer in the same hospital. I said to him, say, no, be our people. That's what he told me. See, they are not their people.
They just give them a place to stay.
So it's a business thing. They collect money from everybody to come around.
The truth is actually that the hospitals are not the ones registering children.
Okay.
Childbirth is not registered by the hospital. We have officials of the National Population Commission who are assigned. They are given a desk or an office in all the hospitals to register births. And it is these hospitals that it is these officials that are collecting the money. But we have also gone for those who are inquisitive to say, why did you talk to NPC? The National Population Commission officials have also told us that they do not collect money. So it is for you to insist that you are not going to pay. And if you insist you are not going to pay, they will give you your birth certificate, the birth certificate for the baby. Now let's see if we have more calls. Hello. Please, if you call us, put down the volume of your radio set so that we can hear you very clearly. Hello, what's your name, sir?
Destiny Anthony.
Destiny Anthony.
Yes. I think back to my general people. But I want to say something. We know that they issued like hundreds from different hospitals. I know that it could be only 10 people that will collect that in free. If you go there, insist that no, it's free to pay me for bridge. And no, most times because you have other things to make, you don't want to keep your child or your wife by that place, you have to go. They collect these things, it's not like they don't know. We know that this is just going to be in our system. It's a different thing if somebody comes and tells you plainly, okay, it's free. And then he tells you, find me water to drink. I mean, if the one person tells you that it's 500 naira, or another tells you that you need to pay 1,000 for stamping, or to bring it from office 500 naira. What are we talking about?
No.
Nobody collects that in free. If people collect it free, it's just like 10%.
Don't you think, Mr. Anthony, don't you think if Nigerians insist that they are not paying, no matter what happens, because there's no rope on your neck at the hospital, you can actually go home and come back to do the registration later, but it is free, whether in their office or in the hospital. Don't you think Nigerians should insist?
Yes. Let's just say, maybe you are the person issuing the receipt at the hospital. But I'm the same person attending to you. Maybe your silver is behind me. You have another person behind me, like three other people. The moment you start insisting and making noise, you'll be sure that you might see your silver, my guy, that will say, I'm just joking and this thing for more than the phone. I'm not saying that your silver does lie, but I'm just saying the way people can experience the one. So when you don't feel like I have like three or four other people, they are telling you, pay.
instead of standing like you are the only holy man.
You pay. Please want to encourage Nigerians to stand as the only holy man.
Imagine.
Yes, stay and say you are not paying. Encourage others. Mobilize the others to say this is free.
Absolutely, you are very correct, sir. But I think that is why I have very serious problem with national retention engines. Why are people who are working in that office collecting salary? These people will come back and do their work, buy time on radio stations and keep saying something. You know, when Dora Kudera was there, we had a few things. Once in a while, they would tell you Nigeria something, there was one one that we had. At least that was beginning to build in our subconscious that we can fix this nation.
The NOA should do something.
So they should do something. What are they doing? If they come back, let's just say they come to Nigeria to that life, just like I should, when I think this corruption thing. You invited the slammer is somebody that I know. Whatever he says today will make a meaning to me because somebody like me, I'm so thankful for somehow I know the kind of person he is. If they can go on Nigeria for 5 minutes, 30 minutes, try to talk to Nigeria, try to please return.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you so much. We have asked you to send us our messages on WhatsApp 090-22-65-6167. Let's take a few messages, and that will be, we have some messages.
Yes, we do. This one is from Ola from Buhari, and he said, I paid 2,000 in October 2018 at Buhari General Hospital. Joy Kadiri said she didn't pay a boy she gave birth at Nisa Premier. Peter from Gwagwalada said he paid 2,000 at Gwagwalada Teaching Hospital. Mr. Henry, he said he paid 2,000 for his son at National Hospital, Abuja. Another one said he paid 1,500 at different occasions at Asokoro District Hospital. And someone, Maureen from Duse Alaji, said she paid 1,000 at Maitama General Hospital. And another person said he paid at General Hospital, Suleja, where he collected his child's birth certificate.
All right, let's take more calls. Let's see if we have people. We want to be happy if you have more people saying they didn't pay. And those who paid, let us know, why did you pay? Let's take some call. Hello.
Hello.
That's a female voice too. What's your name? What's your name, madam?
My name is Victoria.
You paid how much?
2,000 naira. It was 4,000 naira. And I did not give birth at the hospital at the time. I did that in specific. I was supposed to use my certificate for my copy for my daughter. And they said I needed international population. So I took my daughter's certificate to the hospital for them to issue the national population certificate.
Were you
aware? So they told me I was going to pay 4,000.
Were you Were you aware that you ought not to have paid?
Yes, I was aware. I was surprised when they told me I was going to pay 4,000. But since they were not going to me if I don't pay, and I needed to use the certificate for something at that time, I didn't have time to start to drop them. But I had to pay the back. But they negotiated. I paid 2,000 at the end of the day.
Thank you very much, madam. Negotiated from four to 2,000. Hello. Hello.
Hello. My name is Ogidi.
It's my Ogidi.
Yeah.
Okay, go up, please.
I paid 1,000 naira of federal medical staff just in Abuja two occasions.
Why did you pay when you know or you didn't know it was free?
I didn't know they forced me to pay the same, which everybody I'm paying, I'll pay my own.
So you were not aware that it was free?
I'm not aware. I'm just hearing it.
Now, if you were aware, what would you have done?
I will insist that I'll try my best to stop it, but people are paying, so I paid my own.
did you hear the cost of his effort?
All right, thank you.
I will try my best, but people are paying.
Hello. Hello.
Thank you. My name is Fred. I'm calling from Suleja.
Your name is?
My name is Sunday. Calling
Sunday.
From Suleja.
Yes, Sunday from Suleja. Go ahead, please.
So, my own idea is that why people pay, sometimes when people are desperate to get that paper, they can pay. So, even though they are aware So what my friend is that those agencies, those group of people asking people to save, they are the ones that they need more orientation. Not just to put them there and telling them, don't ask people to pay, or it's free, or it's free, or people are corrupt. So they are the ones to a kind of rebrand them, pay them the necessary, why the people shouldn't pay. This is absolutely free. So don't attack people, don't attack any Nigerian kobo. So not just to put them there and say, it's free. Now, their mind is very wicked. So for them to give that paper free, they think they are cheated. Why should I write this in for this person free? Am I here because of so that is Nigerian. So let the people, let those who are regulating them, give them more orientation. Let them see how much more, how much right Nigeria have to get that free. So. Now, for example, police. Now, I usually travel around Nigeria. So, where is the police collecting money? But on the air, I hear that police is their friend. No same bribe to police. No, this was very free. But police are collecting money.
All right,
so
thank you.
Why are they not orientating police? Why are they not giving police instruction?
Okay.
Don't do this to any human being. It's very, very bad.
So all right. Thank you. So.
Yeah, now I bring this up.
Okay.
Okay. I feel for my own children. Federal Medical Center, Jabi. 1,000. And the truth is, I don't look at this in as stuff. They free.
You didn't
know. Honestly, if I know, I would die. Chigba. I know, Bian, I will collect that registration.
That's a good Nigerian. That's how to stand. That is how to
stand. Honestly, in fact, the thing just... And the well as they tell me say
the
well as it don't say the 1,000 or anything, you know. Job like this, they don't cheat me.
Have another baby.
Other children, so we'll take out more from there.
When the background actually, Mr. Aslam, is that people say it's just small, just pay. But if you have 500 babies in Abuja, maybe even say 500 babies in Abuja in 1 week. I don't want to say one day.
Yeah.
In 1 week, 500 babies, and they are paying just 1,000. That's 50,000.
They make so much money from business, I tell you. Just try and visit, say, this public hospital, for instance. I think they deliver like on daily basis over 10 to 15, at a point, even much more than that. The day my wife gave birth, my last baby, we had about, as time I left the place, this was about a few minutes after 12. What about 9, even before I came?
Yes.
You know, as I was still waiting, so I was still coming in, give birth, you know, put into the water, I love all that. So it's a business. They are making a lot of
money. Okay, let's take WhatsApp call now.
Mr. Hamzi said he paid 1,000 at General Hospital Bwari. He was not aware that it's free. And we also have Alfred from Airport Road. He said he paid 500 naira. Because he's a teacher and he knows the importance of the birth certificate, he encouraged parents to go and get the birth certificate. He had to call NPC staff to come to the school to register these pupils. Initially, it was 600, but after a while, the NPC official told him that they have to pay 3,000 naira.
Okay.
So he felt that they were extorting parents and decided to stop the process.
Wonderful. That was a good teacher.
That's a good one.
A good one who says, did you register your children?
Yes.
Please? Let us call the NPC officials. And they came and they were extorting from 600
in the process.
From 600 to 3,000 naira. Mr. Asilaja, we must thank you so much for joining us on the program. And for those who still want to share their experience with us, please go straight to our WhatsApp line 090-2265-6167. That is 090-2265-6167. And we have other platforms you can reach us at. Official Primog is our social media platforms, whether on Facebook, on Instagram, or on Twitter. And you can also send a message to us through our email, and that is info@primong.org. info@primong.org. Chukudukule Gbaja. We have a harvest of information for our people, and I'm excited that people are getting to know that it is wrong to pay for birth certificates. And if you give birth to a child, insist on free birth certificate, and that is what the rules are in Nigeria.
It's a deluge of responses, and I'm very happy about it. The awareness has gone out properly, and I think Nigerians should begin to stand their ground over these things.
Your last word, Mr. Asilam.
Like he said, of course, like I saw the movie before now, I'm well aware that it's for free. But I cannot help it, so okay. I have to pay. I have to pay the money, I have to get it. But of course, Nigeria should know this thing is free.
Thank you so much for joining us on the program today. And for those who joined us on phone and on WhatsApp platform and on our social media platforms, we want to appreciate you. Please continue to send us your messages. And in this area, we are concerned, and we'll get the NPC involved and the NOA to see how we can popularize the freedom to take your birth certificate without paying for it. And that's how we're wrapping up. Chukwudukulegbaja, the last word from you.
It's been a good outing. The more aware Nigerians become, the more they can insist on their rights. Let us not, for 1 minute, shirk our responsibilities to ourselves.
And that's how we're wrapping it up. Join us again, same time next week, for another edition of Public Conscience, with the support from the Makato Foundation. My name is Okiri Agbonsuremi.